Hey guys, welcome back to Film Ash. This is the episode for November 8th, and this is actually kind of a special episode because it's the first time we're actually doing an official series. Like, we're doing a repeat of a previous concept.
Yep.
If you guys remember a couple weeks ago, I think exactly a month ago, I believe.
Yeah,
just we about. Did Reservoir Dogs recasting, but with modern male actors.
Yes.
And this time, we're doing modern female actors.
So, which, 27 years later.
27 years later.
Who would be playing
all female cast? I did a little bit of research, and apparently there's people have been doing this as stage productions for a while.
Really?
So we're not original, but
oh, no. I never claimed to be original. That.
But yeah, no, there's been all female productions of Reservoir Dogs on stage for a little bit now.
That's awesome.
So yeah, I mean, if that ever comes anywhere near us, I would very much love to see that because that just sounds rad. Yeah. Of course, my big brain thought of it years after they did, so must be a good idea. Great minds think alike.
Cool, cool.
So Dan, I believe I went first last time.
Okay.
So if you want to go first this time, so, go for it.
This is Miss Pink.
Mm-hmm.
Originally Mr. Pink, Steve Buscemi's character. Again, I pretty much did a copy-paste because, you know, we're still looking at the same character.
Yeah.
Kind of a talkative, bit of an outsider, logical, down-to-earth. But I was trying to think of an actress who could play a role who's not afraid, who doesn't shy away from these kind of more out-there roles.
Okay, so I don't think we have the same person.
Okay.
I was thinking about the same person, this one, I don't think so anymore.
And I think, honestly, when I was looking at it, this was kind of the only person who made sense for me. I mean, I didn't do a wide search for Miss Pink, but I ended up going with Aubrey Plaza.
Okay, I almost went with Anna Kendrick. That wasn't the choice I went with, though. Aubrey Plaza is genius, though. I am bummed I didn't think of it. My choice is much more out there. It's someone we both know, but I might have to like tell you who she is.
Okay.
But no, just to go on your choice for a little bit longer, Aubrey Plaza is really
smart.
So
Aubrey Plaza from obviously Parks and Rec fame, from Legion fame, mm-hmm. personally. Again, she's always had a very good way of finding roles that are outside, I feel like, the common arc.
Yeah.
Of what you might see from mm-hmm. a female
she's
character.
She's a very talented comedic actress, but with Legion especially, she's shown she's capable of like doing the weirdest stuff like you can imagine.
I always appreciate her dramatic work so much because she just has a certain outsider flair to it.
That, yeah, you know, exactly.
I really like, you know, every time I see Aubrey Plaza is going to be something new, I'm like, let's
you know,
do
you
it.
You know the
I'm
story
ready.
Where she freaked out Werner Herzog?
Yes.
Which, you know, if you can freak out Werner Herzog, you're a very unique kind
on
of person.
Set of Parks and Rec, she asked Werner Herzog, have you ever seen a ghost? And he flipped out.
Yeah, so if you make Werner Herzog uncomfortable, you're definitely a special kind of person.
Heck
no,
yeah.
Aubrey Plaza is a great choice.
I went
with more, because I originally was going to go with Aubrey Plaza. And Anna Kendrick.
Okay.
I was going to go with Anna Kendrick, which they're actually friends, which is like, that's a weird connection there.
That's cool.
But I was like, she's a little too peppy, and she's a little too like light and bubbly for Ms. Pink.
That's what kind of got me, too.
And I was talking to Clay about this. For those of you who don't know, Clay is my roommate, who was on the second episode of Filmand. He said she's not really a female Steve Buscemi. And that got me thinking about who a female Steve Buscemi is. And I think of Steve Buscemi, I think naturally comedically talented. Yep. He's goofy looking, but in a very cool way. He has a very unique look to him. And I think someone who is funny, and they've proven they're funny on multiple occasions. They've done a lot of guest roles on like mm-hmm. little tiny movies. Like they were in Jurassic World, which is a big movie, but they were a very tiny part in it.
What?
And I'm using Lauren Lapkus. That's why I thought like you like Between Two Ferns, the movie, and she's really good in that.
Lauren
so
Lapkus
I was like, maybe like, the brain chemistry there would connect. Lauren Lapkus is my choice.
That's pretty good. I like that pick. That's a good pick. I can appreciate that for sure.
Yeah.
Honestly, for me, I think my thing against Lauren Lapkus is I feel like she has a bit too much of the Kendrick in her as well.
Yeah, she's
like,
a little
at
too
least
bubbly, maybe.
From her past roles. But like Between Two Ferns is I'm glad you brought that up because she does go a bit adult comedy with that movie, which I really
so
appreciate.
Great.
But like, what was some of your justification behind that?
I don't know. Well, the female Steve Buscemi thing, I feel like she has some of the kind of the same energy he did, especially in the 90s.
Okay.
I think they're she's very talented as an actress. I've like only seen her like little tiny parts, but I've always mm-hmm. like always liked her.
Yeah.
It's someone I never knew her name, but I was like, whoever played that person, I really like her. And I feel like that was kind of Steve Buscemi back in the day when he was a little bit more of a character actor. It's like, I don't know who that guy is, but I really like that guy.
Absolutely.
And I feel like she has that same energy.
Cool. Yeah.
So you ready That's to move awesome. On to yes. Miss Orange, Dan?
Miss Orange.
And I can go so first this
you'll
time.
You'll go first. This is so if Tim you remember, Roth, Tim, yeah, Tim Roth's character.
Remember from last time, I cast Ryan Gosling because yeah. he's the best screamer in Hollywood for a guy. Now, Dan, for Ms. Orange, I cast the best female screamer in Hollywood, which once you hear it, I think you'll agree with me.
Okay.
If you've seen Ready or Not, you know Samara Weaving is the best female screamer in Hollywood. And I can Samara picture her in that suit Weaving. In the back of that car doing her weird goat scream, like covered in blood. I think, and also when you see who I cast as Miss White, I think you'll kind of see those work together really well. I think Samara Weaving is a perfect choice for Ms. Orange.
How did I not think of that?
Yeah.
How did I, that's like we saw Ready or Not together. Yeah. That was so good. Man, she does. She, oh my goodness. Yeah, you had that. I remember you said that you had that from the
yeah,
last
no,
one.
Yeah, no, she was like, the only one I had Orange right away. The second you were going to do a female Reservoir Dogs, like Samara Weaving has to be Ms. Orange.
That's amazing.
Because a person like Lauren Lapkus, amazingly talented actress. Well, I feel like she hasn't really gotten her big break yet. But if you've seen, well, I think Ready or Not could be her big break. I just don't think she's getting nearly as much praise as she deserves from it.
Yeah.
But if you've seen movies like The Babysitter and Mayhem, she is amazing. And she does a little bit of the goat scream in Mayhem, and I was really happy yeah. to hear it.
The goat scream. Oh, I my goodness. I love the goat scream. For those scream. Of you who don't know, there was a scene where Samara Weaving's in Ready or Not. I believe she's, like, finally confronting whoever's yeah. left in the family about, like, third act.
Yeah.
And she lets out this unholy banshee scream.
Yeah.
It is unreal. I was shook.
Me and Dan were like, I don't know how a human can make that sound.
That was insane.
But no, I just imagine the movie, like, you know, screen's black. Yep. You just hear that scream and you like smash in with her oh in the backseat of the car.
That would be.
It's perfect.
That is a badass way of coming into that. Like,
yeah.
Nice. Okay, well, well, gosh, my Miss Orange.
Yeah, sorry.
Why do I have
you gotta
to follow
me?
That?
I'm sorry.
That was really good, though. I mean, I still like my choice. Again, Miss Orange. I ended up going with Kristen Stewart.
Okay, that's a really solid choice.
Yeah,
that's
for
a very
sure.
solid choice.
Just because, I mean, especially just her performances I've seen, mm-hmm. like especially in Personal Shopper. I mean, Twilight.
She's good. Snow White. She does what the movie tells for Twilight.
She does. Yeah, she's not a slouch.
She's a good actress. She's a very good actress.
She's a good actress. She's talented, and I just really liked the idea of seeing her in Tim Roth's character, because I feel like, despite the obvious of like, oh, Tim Roth is unconscious for half the movie, just like lying yeah. on like that ramp in the warehouse, you know, but for what he does have in it, for his lines, there's a lot of depth there.
Yeah.
You know, again, the mole with a soul,
mm-hmm.
still copyrighted. just, you know, a convincing liar, told about their situation. I feel like she can play that well, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Because, yeah, I think that, for me, that's a good...
Well, this is going to be a lot harder to the ending segment, us actually
I know,
casting
having
this.
To, yeah.
Because so far, all I think our choice is like 4 for 4.
Pretty much.
So we took a break after we did the final cast. Okay, so let's move on to your Mrs. Blonde. Or would you rather me do Ms. Blonde first?
I'll do Ms. Blonde.
You go Ms. Blonde first.
Yeah. Okay.
Hopefully we have the same wavelength on this.
Oh, I hope so.
Because mine's a weird choice.
That's
but
the
I
thing.
Think I can explain
okay,
it to
okay.
you.
Okay, for me, Ms. Blonde, Michael Madsen character, cool, collected, but with a crazy streak.
Mm-hmm.
Someone you can see kind of go the nutso streak
yeah.
of like cutting off an ear. I actually went with 2.
Okay.
I have 2. This is the only one I did 2 for because
okay.
I was torn between both of these. These are both actresses I've enjoyed in almost all the stuff they've been in.
see, I don't know. I don't know if you like this person or not.
Ooh, I mean, I don't
see.
Know. We'll
okay,
see.
Just,
so
the anticipation's killing me.
This is so I ended up going with Maggie Gyllenhaal and Zoe Saldana.
Very different choices.
Oh!
Very different. We okay. went like opposite directions.
Really?
I'm so, okay. Explain your 2
okay.
picks.
Okay. So,
which I like both those picks. By the way, those are both
thank
very
you.
Solid choices.
Thank you. Maggie Gyllenhaal. I mean, Donnie Darko.
Mm-hmm.
The Deuce.
Dark Knight.
Dark Knight. Dark Knight. Exactly. Some great dramatic roles. Talented actress, and I feel like. She's not someone I've ever seen go crazy.
Mm-hmm.
She's not really so like she usually has a very like lackadaisical sense to her or something that's like very free flowing
yeah.
with her roles, as much as they can be, you know. But I would just want to see her take on the role of Miss Blonde. You know? Like, wouldn't you just want to see Maggie Gyllenhaal go crazy? You know, like, I would just want
to
see that.
I'm so excited for you to hear my pick.
Oh, man. And then, of course, Zoe Saldana.
Yeah. But she has the crazy streak in her. She does. Zoe Saldana. Zoe Kravitz would be a weird choice, too. But
that would be something else, man. But yeah, this is kind of the same thing, you know, Avatar, Guardians, Star Trek. It's again, like, I'd want to see her in a very active, physically active role. Like, I think that's a really cool place for her, but go ahead.
So, my Miss Blonde, like, we talked to Zac Efron and Michael Madsen, they're kind of big and physically intimidating. And I feel like that's a little bit a part of Mr. Blonde's character.
Yeah.
My Miss Blonde is definitely not physically intimidating in a way. But I think this actress, if you've seen movies that she's in, particularly, I'm not going to spoil it for you, but particularly David Fincher movies she's in that involves a very particular tattoo, I think Rooney Mara would be an outstanding Mrs. Blonde. She is a very different take of the character, but she is, like, she's terrifying. Imagine Rooney Mara dancing to that song, holding the straight razor, like, wearing this cool suit.
Oh, God.
It's terrifying.
It is. It really is.
I think you change the character to be a little less cool and a little more, like, off-putting off the bat. You have it be like Mrs. Blonde is, like, people are immediately afraid of her right away.
Yeah.
So what do you think of the Rooney Mara choice?
Okay.
Do you like it?
It's okay. Out there once. I actually considered her just for a minute for Pink.
Yeah.
For Buscemi's character.
Because she could do both.
She could easily do both. That's the thing. That's what kind of got me. But, man, go with the dragon tattoo. I don't know how I feel about that. That's crazy. That's an out there pick for me. Yeah.
That's my one out there pick. My white is very kind of safe.
Yeah.
Which I guess it means it's my turn to do white, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So I think I know who you're going to pick.
You think you're going to go? Okay. How about this? How about you guess who you think I'm going to do?
No, I can't guess.
You just said you think you know.
I think I know yours
because I know you well enough.
Oh, nuts.
Well, okay, so my wife.
No, it's not Tilda Swinton.
It's not?
It's not okay, Tilda Swinton. I know that's what you're going to.
That was immediately my guess. You're going to do Tilda
really?
Swinton. I did not do Tilda Swinton either.
Okay.
I did an actress who is obviously very good because I like quality actresses. Recent Academy Award winner, but I believe she's won a few times before. It is someone I can see in a motherly supportive role for Orange. And it's an actress that's actually worked with Samara Weaving before, and that's Frances McDormand.
Oh, yes.
Yes. I like that. But she worked with her on Three Billboards.
That's awesome. Frances McDormand, if you don't know, obviously from Fargo, Fame, Burn After Reading, Three Billboards.
She's worked with the Coens a lot dating Joel Cohen, I believe.
No,
or is it
really?
Ethan? Is it Ethan? They have a son together. They're not married, but they have a child together, yes. They've adopted a son, I believe.
No, what? Joel. It's Joel.
Joel.
I looked it up. Spouse since...
Oh, they're married. Okay.
Since 1984.
Yeah. Because they met on Blood Simple, I believe.
Really?
I think so. I could be totally wrong about Frances McDormand's family history. Okay, Dan, we got to kind of speed up your choice. We're running out of time.
Okay, I do like your choice. I think that's really good. I like... Yeah. Anyways, okay, so quickly, my Mrs. White, obviously Harvey Keitel, old, experienced, weathered, but with an emotional hot spot. I originally went with Ken Watanabe back in the last episode for the males, but for the females, I ended up deciding with Alfrey Woodard.
Okay, Alfrey Woodard's a good choice, too.
Yeah? Yeah, I mean, if you see her in Clemency...
she's getting Academy Award buzz for that.
I'm not surprised, honestly. Yeah. Lion King, Luke Cage.
Well, Dan, I like your choice, but in the sake of time and then knowing our final cast list, I guess we're
take a tiny little break.
Yeah.
I'm jumping in with my clothes on.
Most party fouls are pretty dumb, but if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Learn more at ultimatepartyfoul.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Hey guys, welcome back. We're going to give our cast list really quickly. So Dan, you start off.
So our final cast listing is Miss Pink as Aubrey Plaza.
Ms. Orange played by Samara Weaving.
Miss Blonde as Zoe Saldana.
And Ms. White played by Frances McDormand.
I think that is a very good cast list.
Solid cast list.
Yes, I would want to see that movie.
As do I.
I would see that many times.
Well, Dan, sadly, our time this week has come to a close. If you want to follow me and see more opinions and ways we talked about today or in previous weeks, follow me on Letterboxd at Crandberry18. That is CRANDBerry18. Thanks for listening, guys. Catch you next week.